So our team was tasked with designing a wearable robotic suit.
Our project is a hand washing station for use in rural Malawi.
The Houston Zoo asked us to build an enrichment device for the giant anteaters.
So the class is an introduction to engineering design. Each of the teams is working on a client-based project. So there's an individual or a group in the community, such as the Houston Zoo or NASA, that have a particular problem that they need solved. So I think that you're going to need something besides passive gravity to get this to seal back up. So the question is, what could you use to do that? So the students began prototyping only about a week ago. By starting with these really kind of easy to work with materials, the students can go fast and test many ideas, figure out which one works, and then they move on to the higher fidelity materials.
Over 50% of all diseases contracted in Malawi are waterborne illnesses that could be prevented by having a hand washing regularly. And so our project aims to create a station that kind of makes up for the physical lack of equipment that rural Malawi has.
Well, right now we're working on a prototype for the giant anteaters. They live in their enclosure and there's not too much for them to do all day. So we've built a die that has a bunch of different holes in it that we can put food in.
So as humans begin to do further exploration in space, they're going to be spending a long time with robots. So we're designing a suit in order to test these human-robot interactions.
During the second half of the semester, they actually prototype their solutions, build, test, and iterate, so that by the end of the semester, they should have a working design that meets the goals that were set at the beginning of the semester.
So today was our final prototype evaluation. We present the final prototype that we've created to our professors. We show kind of how it works, all the different materials we've used.